Is there any way I can prove this? Sure, let's do it together. This is an example of a geometric series, and I wanted to give you an example first. Right here, when we have a series, you can just think about this as a sum. It's just like a bunch of numbers, and you are adding them up. And those numbers, there's a pattern for it. And right here, I would like to give you an example based on this condition. N is greater than 1. I know everybody will tell me to put 2, but 2 sometimes is too boring. So I'm just going to say N is equal to 3. Example, let N being equal to 3. So this right here, we are going to get a summation as k goes from 0 to infinity. And we will have 1 over 3 and then to the k's power. Now, because n is 3, which is greater than 1, so we can put that in here and here. So we get 3 over 3 minus 1, which we get 3 over 2 for the answer. Done. Now, here's the deal. Sometimes in order to understand a series, it's beneficial if you just expand this. Meaning that if you put 0 into k first, we have 1/3 raised to the 0's power, and then the next number, which is when k is equal to 1. So go ahead and do that. And then continue, 1/3. The next number is 2, and then the next number is 3. And so on. When do we stop though? Well, never, because this is infinity. So you just keep adding forever. And usually you just put down plus dot dot dot. Now, if you look at this, notice that the base is always going to be the same. It's just the exponent is changing. Whenever this happens, we have a geometric series. Because it's just that we take the first number and you multiply by the same number over and over to produce all the terms. To go from here to here, we multiply by 1/3. To go from here to here, we multiply by 1/3. Right, 1/3 times 1/3 is 1/3 to the second power. Likewise, you just keep on doing the same thing. The same number that we keep multiplying over and over, this is called the common ratio. And the notation for that is just r. And in this case, our r is 1/3. So as you can see, this right here, it's like our r, the whole thing inside of the parentheses. Now, in order for a geometric series to converge, in fact, sometimes you might have negative numbers inside of the parentheses here. Sometimes it's okay to have negative common ratio and you still get convergent geometric series. So it's not just that r is less than 1, because if you are talking about r is less than 1, you can say negative 4. That doesn't work. You want to make sure that the absolute value of r is less than 1, and you will make sure you have a geometric series that converge. Absolute value of 1/3 is less than 1, so it works. So this is just a quick overview of what a geometric series is. Now, how are we going to show this formula is correct? Let's do it. So right here, instead of 1 over n, I'm actually going to be using r. It's easier to write that way. So I'm going to start off by saying, let, here is my summation, as k goes from 0 to infinity, and we have r to the k's power. And again, I'm just going to write it out. First, we have r to the 0's power, and that is going to be 1. Again, this is r to the 0's power. And then the next one is r plugging 1, which is r to the first, and then r to the second, and then r to the third. But of course, we just keep on going forever. So in this case here, though, for my proof, I'm going to indicate that I want my r to be with absolute value less than 1. Earlier, when n is greater than 1, 1 over n, of course, it will be less than 1, so that's fine. Now I'm going to call this expression S. So set this to be S. So S is equal to 1 plus R squared plus R cubed, and so on. all the powers of R. We start at 1. Imagine if we take this and multiply by R again. What will happen? Well, we'll still get all the powers of R except for the first one, right? Let me write that down for you. Take R times S again. So all we have to do is take R and multiply all the terms. So R times the first term, R times 1 will be R. But I'm not going to put it down here. I'm going to write it down here. So this is going to be R. R times the next term will give us R squared. So I'll put it down right here. R times this term will give us R to the third power. I'll put it down right here. And R times the next term will give us R to the fourth power. Technically, we also have R to the fourth power here, but I just didn't write it down. Continue the same thing, right? Now, have a look. S, and this is RS. I'm going to subtract that. On the left-hand side, we just have S minus RS. On the right-hand side, well, only one is going to be remaining, right? Because R minus R, they will cancel. R squared will also cancel. Likewise, this and that will cancel. And all the cancellations happening. It's very satisfying. And as you can see right here, we just have a 1. So S minus RS will just give us 1. And remember, we do have the condition that absolute value of R has to be less than 1 in order for this to work. And then right here, we still have to figure out what S is. Factor it out. And then we have 1 minus R. This is going to be 1. And then divide this to both sides. You see, S is 1 over 1 minus R. With that being done, S is that right here, right? So we can conclude that the summation as k goes from 0 to infinity of R to the k's power, it's equal to S, which is just 1 over 1 minus R. And in order for this to be true, as I mentioned it right here, we will have to say absolute value of R is less than 1. Now, I want R to be 1 over N. So all we have to do is plug in 1 over N. And N is greater than 1. You just have to make sure you write it down somewhere. So the whole thing here is less than 1, which is absolute value. Yeah. And then right here, we can just simplify it. Multiply the top and bottom by this N. So the top is just going to be n. Distribute, we get n. Multiply, n cancels. And we get exactly that. That's it.